An important part of my creative process is finding the void. So like at the very beginning of the process when I'm trying to figure out an idea of like what I should make, like I have a basic idea of what that thing should be, right? So it's like a scenario or an adventure or a specific game or a bestiary. And I try to see what's already been done. So like everything has been done, right? Like everything has been created. It's just that the thing that I'm about to create is going to be different. And so in order to figure out how it's going to be different, I have to first figure out what's already been done. So I will like ask Twitter or I will research, you know, this certain thing, how many of these certain things have been done in the gaming sphere already. And then once I look at that, I'll have like kind of a basic idea of what not to do, because all that stuff over there already exists. And while I might want to make something similar to it, I want to try and find like how I can make that variation that will make it new, that will make it, you know, 2019, that will make it me, you know, and not those other things. And that would also make it kind of cool and valuable and different. Like, you don't want to keep buying the same thing over and over again, right? Because that already exists. And at this point in the process, I see a lot of creatives shut down preemptively when they discover that the thing that they're going to make already exists. Like, oh, there are already, you know, hundreds of bestiaries out there, so I can't make one. But the thing is that the thing that you're going to make is going to be different and unique and beautiful, and you should make it, because just because that thing already exists made by this person doesn't mean the thing that is going to exist made by you is going to be the same. It will be different and amazing. I'll like often point people to like, oh, you should look at this and this and this and this, and they'll be like, ah, oh, it already exists, I can't do this idea, I should never make it. And I'm like, no, use that as your research, use that as your starting point. This is a process that I guess I developed in art school, so I feel like I'm cheating a little by having that knowledge, right? Because, you know, when you're first looking to do stuff, you kind of want to have a background of what is already out there. You know, it's like your research in a sense, like you can use it for like how to format something or for the way things look. Or just to have a general sense of like what exists inside of the culture, so that when you're making things, you can use that as like an inspiration point or as a reference to like, hey, this exists in this way, or you can play off of it in fun ways, like, hey, I'm making a dragon, but you weren't expecting this type of riff on a dragon, now were you? And so I think that those, like having an understanding basically of your media or of the thing you're about to make is important when going in to make other things. It also just helps me hone in on that void I was talking about. Like if I can see, oh, these are like the 20 most popular bestiaries, what is it that people like about them? What do I personally like about them? And what it doesn't exist in them already that I would like to see more of and that I think other people would like to see more of. So that's like the perfect void for like, here's the thing I should make. It ticks off like all of these things. And then I know I'm not like making something that's already been made. And I'm making something that, you know, I'm interested in. So potentially other people would be interested in it too. That is my small rant about my creative void searching. How do you look for your void? Or do you do this type of research before you create things? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. And I will see you in my next video. Thanks for watching.